expectation for myself. I accept the challenge to become the best student that I can be. I am proud of my school. The vision of Oakview is to promote a high performing culture and climate to inspire our community of learning to achieve academic excellence. I accept the responsibility for my behavior and its results. I'm determined to be safe, responsible, productive, and respectful. I have high expectations for myself, and I reach my full potential. I choose to be great.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Listen up, Oakview. We are having our winter holiday program on Thursday, December 14th at 7 p.m., taking place at Cedar Grove High School's cafeteria. Oakview Elementary is going to be putting on a performance at Cedar Grove High School cafeteria. You have been practicing in music class with the wonderful Mrs. Ware. Pre-K, kindergarten, make sure you wear your holiday attire. First grade, make sure you wear a white top. Second grade, wear a green top. Third grade, wear a red top. Fourth grade, wear a yellow top. And fifth grade, wear a black top. All students will wear black bottoms. Bring your parents, bring your neighbors, bring your entire family to the winter holiday program taking place Thursday, December 14th, 7 p.m. at Cedar Grove High School.
We're as close as follow the rules.
What's going on, you guys? Miss J. Moore.
Strawberry Jam.
More Minute Math creator. Extraordinaire. Fifth grade teacher. All that good stuff.
Is there any other thing that you do except for being a teacher?
Yes, there are, you know, a couple things that I do. I won't name all of them, but I do sing. I have a little me, a little voice. I'm actually in movies. I act. Won't tell y'all what it is, but definitely act. I make movies, I write. Those are just a couple things that I do. I DJ, definitely DJ. Yes, I DJ party. Shout out to Mr. Danzo, AKA DJ Super Crump, for teaching me how to DJ. Blessings to you.
How does being a teacher like inspire you? How does the kids inspire you, like teaching them things?
Okay, the kids inspire me. Like, believe it or not, you guys have so much personalities. Like, there's so many different personalities in the room whenever I'm teaching. But I see teaching, since I'm a performer, I see teaching as like a performance. And I perform a certain amount of time each day for you guys, whether I perform math, whether I perform science, whatever. So you guys inspire me to put on my best performance so that way you guys can have the best result, aka pass the milestones, pass your formative assessments, all of that. So you guys inspire me to do my best performance because at the end of the year, I want a standing ovation. I want you guys to stand up and be like, Strawberry Jail, you had me pass that test. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? So that's how you guys inspire me. Put on my best performance like I do outside of school.
Do you take videos of yourself singing, like, or do you post on social media what you're singing about?
I do. I did one cover. I posted it on TikTok. I am on TikTok. Blame my kids. They the ones that got me on TikTok. If it wasn't for them, I would not be on TikTok. But I am on TikTok. Strawberry Jam, I am. Very kid-friendly. And I do sing sometimes. Like, I might make another cover, maybe, and put it on there. But I know I have at least one on there. So I do like to sing, you know, do musicals and stuff. So, yeah.
We already know that you have a TikTok page, and I see that you post your kids a lot.
Yeah, I do.
Like, the start of the school year, I saw a couple of the kids in your class. Uh-huh. And how does that make you feel?
I like it. I used to not really post kids that much on my timeline, just for the sake of, you know, I just want to make sure that they're performing the way they need to in class first, because of course academics come first. Academics come first, then the fun comes after. So putting my kids on there just a little bit here and there, it kind of also opens more of another layer of relationship as well between myself and the kids. So it's just like, hey, yeah, Miss Moore is really tough on us, but also, you know, she does TikToks with us, you know, like it's like a, oh, another layer of that's a cool relationship that we have, you know. And yet I'm still handling business in the classroom.
Thank you. Thank you for telling us a little about yourself.
Thank you.
We'll see you guys next time. Bye.